Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, this is your CNC HD and this is another Hall of Fame replay. This time on Forgotten Forest. And this time we have Skrillex here on the bottom left corner with his Sion Tank General. And on the top position we have Yunik with his China Infantry in the pink color. So let's hope for a very entertaining matchup here and for a good fight. So this match has Hall of Fame footage here, so let's see. Alright, so this map is really low on cash, so you need to be very careful here with your money spending. Because you only have the main supply and 7 cash crates. And also there are 2 Aldarecs here on the map, so most of the time it comes to an oil fight. So which player can have this Aldarec early enough and who can save the Aldarecs. Alright, so let's take a look on the build orders. Yunik is going for 2 supplies and he is building up in a war factory. And Skrillex is also building 2 supply centers and 2 war factories. So he is the tank general, he is going for a lot of tank spam. So this is a good decision from a tank general, building 2 war factories and just spamming a lot of tanks. And we have a propaganda center here from Yunik, an early propaganda center, so we can expect an early Lotus here soon. This can be very interesting now. So Skrillex going for early aggression and Yunik is going for fast tech. Let's see how this turns out. I'm very excited. Now we have the first listening outpost of Yunik and he's going to shake hands here with Skrillex. Also has a listening outpost here and both are shaking hands now with the rockets. And who will survive? Yunik survive by not taking so much damage here from the rockets. Now here a flame tank from Skrillex making his way to Yunik. And this listening outpost just ignoring this dragon tank and just going here for the base of Skrillex to get some information about build order or to scout the base for some other reasons, I don't know. Now here Skrillex took the building in the near from of Yunik base, also still have this dragon tank here stand in front of Yunik's base, and this can be a very big problem for Yunik. But Yunik wisely shutting down his flame tank with his ECM tank and now destroying it with this listening outpost. Really good micro here of Yunik shutting down this flame tank. No, random tank hunter tries to destroy this listening outpost, but no success because of this ECM tank. Now we have a Gatling tank here of Skrillex hunting some dozers here in Yunik space, but this listening outpost is already on the track to hunt down this Gatling tank, and it was successful. Now we have a big engagement here, a very big engagement here of Skrillex with a lot of Gatling tanks and a flame tank. But is this successful against a lot of listening outposts? Because what we know is listening outposts just raping those Gatling tanks. But maybe Skrillex can have some really good micro here and destroy those those listening outposts. Now the listening outposts are also guarded by this ECM tank, so no tank hunters can destroy those listening outposts. Now here we have an oil crab here from Yunik on the bottom with his black lotus. I'm wondering, is Skrillex also going for the black lotus? And yes, he is. He's also building a propaganda center, so we can expect an early black lotus here also from Skrillex. And both are going for the oil grab then. Now those listening outposts just raping those Gatling tanks. And those tank hunters cannot deal a lot of damage against those listening outposts because of this ECM tank. Now a dragon tank destroy some troops here, and also a dragon tank from Skrillex stands in front of this war factory, but was shut down early enough. Very good micro here, shutting down this flame tank. Also destroying a lot of Gatling tanks with only three listening outposts and one ECM tank. Well, we have another flame tank here from Skrillex coming over the bottom flank, but a listening outpost is taking care of this threat and just destroying this dragon tank. Now another dragon tank here from Skrillex, so Skrillex really loves his dragon tanks, but those listening outposts are just everywhere and they can take care of those dragon tanks easily. Now shutting down this flame tank with the ECM tank again and now destroying it. Now we have a Black Lotus here near to this oil derrick. Also another Black Lotus here, also near to this oil derrick from Skrillex. So two Lotuses are running directly to this oil derrick at the same time. Oh, I didn't saw this often. I see this the first time, to be honest, and both Lotuses are grabbing this oil derrick at the same time. And who is faster, Skrillex or Yunik? And Yunik is faster, taking this oil derrick with a millisecond faster than Skrillex. Both Lotuses are now standing here. We have a big engagement here on the bottom. Three listening outposts and an ECM tank against a lot of Gatling tanks and a listening outpost. But luckily, Yunik has a ECM tank here in the mix. Now, both Lotuses are running here. One hunting another. But if this Black Lotus is detected, this does not mean some good things here. And Lotus should go into this building and not getting shot by this Gatling tank. But this Gatling tank is now shooting at the Lotus and... Ah, Yunik losing his Black Lotus to this Gatling tank. Now those listening outposts are doing some damage here. First listening outpost is already destroyed. And this listening outpost is nearly destroyed. And a lot of Gatling tanks sitting here, but one is near to death. But this army is just raping now those two oil derricks, listening outposts, I wanted to say, and an ECM tank. This ECM tank is now shut down by this ECM tank. Nuclear reactor, and we have a nuclear missile silo from Yunik. I do not agree with this nuclear missile. I really don't agree with this. This is, we are 8 minutes in the game and there is a really expansive nuclear missile on the field with no power. Now it has power, but he really should invest this money into troops. But let's see how this turns out. Also 6 minutes to shoot and it does not deal a lot of damage, this nuclear missile. But let's see. Now some mix here on the field from Skrillex, shooting on those listening outposts, but luckily here's an ECM tank and another. Now this ECM tank shutting down some tanks, and this might be a GG moment here, because Skrillex now has a really good position here now. All the attack units of Yunik are destroyed. Now Yunik can Yunik tries to rebuild his army, but it's only a matter of time till Skrillex send another wave. And now we have Black Lotus here from Skrillex capturing this war factory, but war factory is just sold in time, and we have another war factory here scaffold from Yunik immediately rebuilding it. And Black Lotus is again capturing a building, but need to cancel it because here's a minigunner, and Black Lotus don't want to have bullets in her face. Sure, so she retreats. Now we have, wow, did you hear that? Two artillery strikes at the same time launched. Here, carpet bomber but no carpet bomber off Skrillex, so two artillery strikes and the first goes on the airfield and the second destroys this war factory and a barracks. And Skrillex dealt more damage than Yunik. Skrillex destroyed a war factory and a barracks. Yunik only an airfield without a mix. But his carpet bomber hit the building here, I guess the propaganda center was the target and it was destroyed successfully. Now the Black Lotus was shot by this listening outpost. And those mix are just flying around here destroying the listening outpost and not this supply truck. Now another Gatling tanks and two flame tanks coming to the near to the base of Yunik over the top flank, and Yunik does not have a lot here. He has two listening outposts and the same tank, but Skrillex also doesn't have enough here to destroy those listening outposts. Those listening outposts are just enough to destroy those troops. Now Yunik is building up an internet center. So 11 minutes in the game and he decides to go now on hackers. Now those mix shooting on those listening outposts, destroying one listening outpost, destroying not the second listening outpost, but the ECM tank was destroyed. Now this listening outpost of Skrillex doing some huge damage against this outposts here. And Skrillex again is in a good position here. He has two flame tanks, three Gatling tanks, and Yunik only have one listening outpost. So he needs to be very careful and has a lot of micro to deal some good damage against this huge force of Skrillex. Now a flamer tank is creating a flame tank is creating a flame wave, killing two tank hunters. Flame tank was shut down. Oh, now four mix destroying this listening outpost, and we have another carp bomber off Yunik, but almost hitting nothing, but could manage to destroy those two, those three Gatling tanks with one bomb. And this attack is defended somehow, and Yunik lives on. Yunik still have this oil derrick, so Skrillex didn't have in mind to destroy this oil derrick yet, or didn't capture it yet. This is a lot of money for Yunik, especially on this map where the money is really low. You need to destroy this oil derrick. Don't let this one survive for such a long time. Now another attack wave of Skrillex is making its way to Yunik's base. Yunik has two listening outposts again and an ECM tank, but those mix are shooting on those listening outposts, destroying one listening outpost. And now it's only one listening outpost and an ECM tank against four Gatling tanks and two outposts. Now this listening outpost is destroyed. And is this another GG moment? It looks like it. Yunik can't do nothing now. He tries to build a flame tank, but not a lot of success here. And now Skrillex could put a Gatling tank in front of his barracks, and this would be GG here for this barracks. Now we have also a Helix from Skrillex dropping down a flame tank, but the nuclear missile was launched. Let's see what it's hitting, and it's firing directly here, but didn't destroy anything, only a reactor and a dozer. So this nuclear missile was not worth its money and time investment. War factory survived just barely. This was not a good shot here, but as I said, nuclear missile silos are just crap. They're so weak. And now this Helix is still alive and destroying some trucks, and now we have artillery coming from Yunik, and this flame tank destroyed now those listening outposts. And this artillery nearly destroyed this airfield, destroyed this supply center here. And this war factory. And Skrillex tried to rebuild his propaganda center. Now you have an artillery barrage from Skrillex hitting the internet center, killing some hackers here from Unic. Unic lost all his hackers now. Now this Helix still alive. 2-star promoted now. He can now heal himself. And the base of Skrillex does not look good. Does not looking so good. My English is so bad right now. Airfield nearly destroyed. War factory nearly destroyed. Supply center is a piece of junk right now. The only thing what's looking good now is this command center, dozer, and the nuclear reactor. Notice Helix is still alive. And we have 2 flame tanks coming from Skrillex, making its way to Unic. And Unic, what does Unic have? He has 1, 2, 3 minigunners. And is rebuilding his propaganda center. So 3 minigunners against 2 flame tanks. 2 mix. And yeah, Helix on top of that. Now minigunner is just shaking hands with this flame tank. Minigunner runs away. Flame tank ignores this minigunner. What a great moment here. Now this flame tank is in front of this command center, flaming down this command center, and it looks like that he's successful. Now this MiG destroyed this listening outpost. This flame tank successfully destroys this command center. This does not look good for Unic again. For the third time, it does not look good for Unic. And this flame tank is still alive. And is he doing some serious damage again? Ah, it's now shot by this minigunner. Ah, but this Helix took care of those minigunners. Another flame tank here from Skrillex, creating another flame wave, but not destroying anything. Helix still alive. Some minigunners standing around here, waiting for some Helixes to shut them down. Unic is sitting on very low cash, but has a Black Lotus here. Skrillex now dropping a Battlemaster, but this Black Lotus is in position and shutting this Battlemaster down. And now this listening outpost is taking care of this Battlemaster. So this Battlemaster drop was a bit of a waste here. Wasn't good try, but was waste. Now 4 supply trucks making its way to Unic base. Don't know why, maybe to drive over some minigunners. This will be the case here, I guess. They drive it directly to this minigunner and kill him successfully. Yep, there it goes. And this Lotus does a long shutting down to this flame tank. Flame tank is shut down. Those supply trucks try to drive into this listening outpost, but no success. This listening outpost is destroying all those supply trucks. Lotus again shutting this flame tank down. Meanwhile, Unic is rebuilding this command center. This flame tank gets destroyed by this listening outpost. And finally, Skrillex destroyed this oil derrick. This order gave Unic over 15,000 cash, I believe. Was a lot of money coming from this order to Unic. Now we have a carpet bomber of Unic targeting Skrillex base, and this can deal a lot of damage, can destroy a lot of buildings here if targeted right. And the war factory is gone, and airfield and reactor nearly destroyed. Now we have an artillery strike of Unic. Meanwhile, this Helix and the Gatling tank are destroying this dozer. Here's a mine, I guess. Yes, there are mines. And this artillery barrage destroys this war factory. Was it the airfield? I already forgot it. But this building was destroyed. Black Lotus sitting here off Unic. Shutting down this Gatling tank now. Helix still alive. 2-star promoted, and this base of Skrillex does not look good. It's not looking very good here. Only one command center and a nearly destroyed reactor. Listening outpost is taking care of this dragon tank, and the base of Unic is looking the same as the base of Skrillex. Now this power reactor was sold by Skrillex. And didn't saw it blew up, so it was sold. And if this Helix would have a Gatling can, and now it has a Gatling can. This Helix now has a Gatling can, destroyed this Lotus. The Lotus was the only hope now of Unic to destroy the base of Skrillex. And now this Helix. This Helix, man, this can be the turning point here now. In this match, this Helix can now rape everything. Unic only has one missing outpost left. And if this Helix microed correctly, then this will be GG again for Unic. Fourth GG time now. Now only two units on the battlefield. Helix and Listening Outpost. Oh man, what an exciting match this is. 22 minutes in the game. And let's see who's taking the win. Listening Outpost is driving directly to the command center. And the Helix saw it for a bit of a time, but now saying, no, I ignored it. I will now go for the base of Unic. Now this dozer is falling to this Helix. And this Listening Outpost is now targeting this command center, and there was a Battlemaster drop of Skrillex trying to destroy this Listening Outpost, but no success. And now here's dozer standing, repairing this command center. Oh, a carpet bomber of Unic! Destroying this, this dozer, and now this command center cannot be repaired. Also artillery barrage, but what was that? Now Helix destroying this Listening Outpost. Oh, this is very close, this is very close. Oh, Helix survived just barely. What the fuck? If this artillery was targeted correctly, this command center would have been destroyed and Unic would have taken this win now. This carp bomber was already used, and this artillery was already used. Only this Helix is now on the field. Two buildings to destroy, and then it's a win for Skrillex. We have another mine drop here from Unic, but this is useless. And if Unic can somehow pull out the win of this, I don't know what I'm doing then, but it would be so epic. Throwing some mines on the command center, how useless. This can take a while, but this should be GG here right now. Unic has nothing. Carbon bomber is used already. Artillery is used already. And this Helix just destroying this command center. What? No, seriously? No. 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 No way. Unic somehow has another artillery. No. No, this is not true. If this... Helix, no! Oh! God damn it! What the match here! Oh my god! What? Oh my god! Artillery barrage came out of nowhere in the last seconds and destroyed this command center of Skrillex. Oh my god, what a close ending here. And I don't want to know how Skrillex is feeling at this moment right now. This Helix could destroy this command center, but was too late. And oh, what a game. Oh man. Whew. What an exciting match. And this was the new Hall of Fame replay. And I hope you liked it. If you want to see this replay, you can go to gamereplays.org, replay section, Hall of Fame. There it is, Unic vs. Skrillex on Forgotten Forest. This was, of course, your CNC HD. If you want to see more casts of me, you can go to my website, cnchd.weebly.com. There is everything well sorted. And I thank you for watching. This was your CNC HD.